Good afternoon, YouTube. So I wanted to do a brief update on my 12-volt cooling fan here. One thing I guess I didn't make really clear in the video was this is strictly to blow a little bit of cooling air on myself. It's not meant to cool the whole shop or do anything like that. It's just a fixed fan to circulate a little bit of air over myself. And where it really helps is when you're wearing like safety glasses. These tend to trap a lot of heat. If you have a tight-fitting safety glass that fits close around your face to protect your eyes, you get a lot of heat trapped behind the lenses. I always wear these working on the lathe, and having that little blast of air in the face really helps. One thing I noticed was this fan was much noisier than the two fans I put in my solar garden shed for cooling. One of the fans I have in the shed is running without a grill, and then the other one is running with one of these wire grills. So anyway, I was suspecting that the noise was coming from this 3D printed grill that's part of the fan bracket. Let me bring the microphone up here and you can hear the sound. Now let me bring up this particular grill here and we'll see if that picks it up. But I think this particular grill is letting hexagonal columns of air through, and then the fan blades are chopping those columns up because of this regular spacing. I think what I'm going to do is put on one of these wire grills, because these have the advantage that the openings are circular, so there's hardly anything to interrupt the airflow. There might be just a very slight increase in noise with this one, so I think I'm going to put this grill on the outside and we'll see how that works here. Okay, there we go. YouTube got the wire grill on there, and I think that's going to work a lot better. You can just barely hear the fan running right up close to it with the microphone. And there it is on the other side. I think that puts out more air too. I think that other grill was blocking the airflow, because I can really feel a lot more air right now. So it goes from about there. That's about the size of the air plume that's coming out of there. I think that works a lot better. So if you're printing one of these fans, I would skip the 3D printed grill, because I don't think that works very well. It's noisy and it restricts the airflow compared to one of these metal grills. Anyway, I just wanted to do an update on the fan. It's definitely working well. It's just a lot more comfortable working here in front of the lathe, because right in here there's the bottom of the cabinet shelf, and then you've got the wall here, so you end up with kind of a dead area in here. The air tries to come in, but it can't rise here, so you just get kind of a dead air space in here. No way for the air to circulate. So this little fan here can blow some of the air from out here, that you get the airflow from that back door to the front door. So there's airflow in that direction, but it doesn't come back this way. So that's the whole idea of this, is just to get a little air blowing in here underneath the cabinet and over the lathe, try to keep me cool. So yeah, I've been running the fan about 2 weeks now. It's running on solar power here. That's my 12-volt DC power that comes off the battery bank and solar panels. So this fan is running off-grid, and it uses very little power, about maybe 2.5 or 3 watts. Doesn't require any power inverter. And it's safe. This is a class 2 DC circuit, so it's a low voltage circuit protected by a 7.5 amp fuse, so it's under what's called class 2 wiring. So it's safe, there's no shock hazard, there's no fire hazard. I think that wire grill is definitely better than the original 3D printed one. That one looks kind of neat, but it is not as functional. Definitely give a thumbs up to the wire mesh grill, and I had a bunch of those in stock. I think I ordered a box of 10 of them at some point, so I have a whole bunch of those. So anyway, hope you enjoyed that update. If you have any other questions about that, post up in the comments section down below. And as always, thanks for watching.